Greetings, basic stagecraft class, and welcome to the Lara Show! Starring me, Lara. Today, you will get to see a few clips of the process of making a glass slipper. So, here we go. Step one is planning and getting materials.
Hi! Good morning, everyone. This is the first step on my shoe because before, we had some technical difficulties. Went to the craft store, talked to the craft guy, long story. But welcome to my little sister's room. And this is what I'm going to use for the first step of my shoe. I'm going to use a base of the regular shoe. These were actually my shoes for my 6th grade celebration. I'm planning on sanding off the bottom and taking off this top piece, and then maybe if we can take me off this piece, it might not be possible. We might have to figure something out there. If we can, we're gonna take that off and take the heel out and build the bottom and around. But right now we're just planning on building around it using like a pretzel tub from what I've seen, and getting the pretzel tub and making a mold and cutting it out and gluing it and molding it some more around the end of the shoe. So hopefully it'll look really good and stuff. So that's step one.
Step two, putting the project together. Okay, we're at step two here now. Good afternoon. This was the original shoe. And I learned a way to do it by using a pretzel tub. I'm trying to kind of use that and evolve it to what I'm doing. So this is the original. This is what I have so far. I wish it wouldn't adjust. Hold on. This is the shoe. You can see it. Put it on the chair, maybe you'll see it better. I made the end out of the pretzel tub, and it is wearable. The only problem I'm having so far is that, as you can see, there is a silver top from where the foot is softer, and then there's a black bottom. And I'm really not too concerned about the silver top as much as the black sole. So that's when I'm where I'm working right now. You can see, because you know it is supposed to be completely clear, though. I am gonna probably leave this. I'll show you it on. It's actually quite comfortable, surprisingly enough. I may keep the shoe, or I may try to get another shoe and use pretty much the same process, except make a different mold. I'm also gonna do and mold around the corner, maybe using the material I have already. Hold on. How does it go? I forgot. How do I do something like this? And then trimming it. So, yeah, that's where I'm at now. Okay, waiting up for next step. Okay. And the final step is finishing touches, getting through all the kinks and putting it all together and making sure it looks really good, and then putting the presentation together. Hi, it's me again. I've gone through a couple different steps with my shoe, so I'm gonna show you. This is the shoe right now. See it? I sawed the black part, the bottom off, literally sawed, and used a claw hammer, handsaw, my utility knife, some scissors, and got that. So that's what I have so far. That's what I'm gonna end up doing to this one. Then I got a thing from the Joanne Fabrics, part of a basket. And I cut out a tracing of the bottom of the shoe. And I'm going to take it and glue on the bottom. Like so. on there, so I'll show you once I get back. And go there. You can stand on it, walk on it. It's still sturdy. And it's still clear. Semi-clear. But yeah, this is my shoe so far. So yeah, okay, bye.
Hey, I'm here really to wrap some things up. So now I'm on the very last step. I'm doing finishing touches on top of it. I added some beadwork to fill in the sidings and to make it more, even more of a shine. I need to re-glue some spots, make sure it's all good, but so far they're all wearable. Fairly see it through and it's looking pretty good. So just gonna shine these babies up and you can see them in class. Okay, thanks. Well, that's a wrap. See you next time on The Laura Show. Do-do-do-do.